Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. It's a fresh start throughout the league here in week one as these two teams have high hopes for the season ahead. It's the Vikings going up against the Titans. With that, let's get you out to Nashville, where we welcome in our new team for 2016, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, thank you, Larry. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee. Today, the opener of the 2016 NFL season between the Minnesota Vikings and the Tennessee Titans.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
They'll run with a second-year man. It's Melvin Gordon. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
So second and nine, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. Now a second down throw for Mariota. He's going to air one out. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
Now the reigning rushing champ, it's Adrian Peterson. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
As a guy carrying the ball, your eyes are going to direct your feet, and you're hoping they carry you to the open spaces. But it's awfully difficult at times because you have so many things you have to look out for. Where's the line blocking? Where's the traffic coming from? Tough to find open spots.
On second down, here's Locke. Oh, he's going to be hit and driven into the turf. Jurrell Casey in there to drop him with his first sack of 2016. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Third and long, it's Locke. And he can't bring it in. Incomplete. He dropped it on the crossing route. Fourth down now. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
So on fourth down, here's a punter, Jeff Locke, to kick it away. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Now a hit and a loose football. It's picked up by the Titans. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
They come up in an offset eye. This is Gordon as they go to him again. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. It's a gain of maybe three, but it's going to leave him with still about eight or nine to go on third down. Quickly now a look at the defensive starters for Minnesota.
Eric Kendricks is another one of those bloodline guys in the NFL. His brother Michael also applies his trade as a linebacker. And Eric's trying to show him he's the best in the family.
On third down, Mariota. And that is incomplete. Tajay Sharp, the intended target. And fourth down coming up.
Well, that was pretty nice to watch if you like a defense's perspective, because they understood where the first down line was as much as the offensive guys did. Did not give up any more ground, and when the ball was thrown, reacted really well and swatted it away. One of the advantages of zone defense, you never take your eyes off the quarterback, and when he reacts, you do exactly the same and go get the ball.
So the flag is for roughing the kicker, a big 15-yard penalty.
And I'm not sure that was the time to go all out after the kicker. Plenty of time left in this game.
They come out here in the eye. Now a play fake here on first down. He'll rifle this. It's caught at the 10. Touchdown, Titans. Tajay Sharp. His first NFL reception goes for six. And the Titans have taken a first quarter lead. And for Mariota, that's the first touchdown pass of the season here in his sophomore campaign.
And do you remember the season opener against Tampa when he was a rookie?
Yeah.
Four touchdown passes, I believe, in the first half of that game. Was absolutely phenomenal and exceptional player. I expect him to just keep getting better because he has it all. Has the height, has the brains, the arm, and, of course, those terrific wheels that will get him out of trouble.
Burst onto the scene last year, getting the first touchdown pass here in 2016. On the return, here's Dree Archer. And he'll probably wish he reconsidered here. It'll cost him 10 yards now with a new rule as he's down at the 15-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. That'll bring up second down. And here's the offense today that hopes to get off to a strong start. To the air, Luck on second down. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jurrell Casey in there to get him. His second sack now in the afternoon. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. To throw on second down is Locke. And complete, right side, the tight end Rudolph. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. Throwing on third down, Luck. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now it's right. An 8-yard return there after a punt of 47. And the Titans will be backed up deep to begin the drive as they take over first and 10. They'll start on the ground. This is Gordon on first down. And he takes us across the 15 to the 17. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They come out here in the eye. They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon trying to get out wide, but he's going to be tackled right near the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Time to tighten up the seatbelt just a little bit, partner, because that was a safety that crashed in there and made that play behind the line of scrimmage. How about that pursuit?
Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. Mariota to throw it, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Sharif Floyd with a big-time sack on 3rd down, and it'll be a loss of 7. With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Titans with a football here to begin quarter number 2. They are, however, facing a 4th down situation. Here's Brett Kern now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Here's Archer. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Vikings, they'll be set up well as they take over in great field position. 1st and 10. And now out comes Minnesota. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
The ball carrier there, Adrian Peterson, he turned 31 back in March.
But after his return from knee surgery a few years ago, that incredible return, I don't think we look at his number the same way as we do a lot of running backs who turn 30.
Yeah, I agree. And right now, standing 17th all-time in the NFL rushing ranks. Here's Luck. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Luck on 1st down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Second down now after the incompletion. On 2nd and 10, Locke. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
As far as I'm concerned, Andrew Luck can do it all. I mean, he's an underrated runner, toughness in the pocket, strong and stout. But let's face it, the money, that comes from his arm.
And smart, valedictorian of his high school class in Houston that he goes to Stanford. He's got it all.
Now a hit and lock. Lost the football. It's out. But a Viking was able to corral this one, and Minnesota will keep possession.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did. It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. So we would have figured that one to be 3 points in the bank, but this game, you know, can be unpredictable at times.
Yeah, he knew he needed to pull it ever so slightly to get it going in the right direction, but he seemed to put a little too much on it. And from short range, that is a bad miss for an NFL kicker.
Now Gordon on first down, and he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. In a 3-4 defense there and against the run, a lot of responsibility can fall on that nose tackle.
A ton of responsibility, no pun intended, because they've got to deal with not just the center, both guards, and a lot of times they have to eat up double teams in order to let the rest of the guys get to the football. But how about that play? He not only did eat up the double team, he ate up the ball carrier as well.
I was going to say, talking about puns, you said eat up the double team. To throw is Mariota. He's going to fire one deep, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith, and his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Second and 10, Luck again. Evans has it left side. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A good pickup there of 20 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. And a short gain down to about the 33. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss.
And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get, because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
Over the middle to Evans. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. Brief break in the action here. back to Tennessee after this. Fresh set of downs here. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Peterson alone in the backfield. He'll get the football here. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
On second down, here's Locke. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
Now Luck. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So without making excuses, you have to figure that this rain has had an impact now on both of his missed field goals.
It's one of those situations really difficult to practice for and tough to prepare yourself against. It's just a whole different animal kicking in the rain, and we've really seen him struggle.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Defense showing blitz. Throwing again. Mariota on second and 10. Over the middle. Sharp's got it complete. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Third down, Mariota. And he finds his target. It's Sharp. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And they're going to speed things up here. A first down throw for Mariota. And complete to the tight end Walker, right side. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense now dealing with a second and 7. Off the play fake, Mariota. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith, and they will take over at the 29-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Flush to his right. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. They rolled out of the pocket right, and I think he wanted a little something more out of that play, obviously. Instead, he hit a safety back.
It looked like two well-coached teams there, even though there was no yardage gain.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Final play of the half here, Mariota. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. So bad mistake there by the kickers. The ball goes out of bounds. They'll come out in the pistol. And off comes to Peterson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Brandon, that play typifies what we've seen from the offense all day long. They've had no success getting things going. I think for the offensive coordinator, he's got to go to that side of the play sheet that says, try something different. Try some specials, something they haven't seen all day to try and get this offense kick-started.
They come out here in the eye. On second down, here's Locke. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Throwing on third down, Luck. And he comes back with one complete. And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. And they take over, they'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. The Titans offense gears up for their first possession of the second half. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll try and get the ground game going. Here's Gordon. And he takes this for about six down inside the 40. See if they stay on the ground for second down.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Got to credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them, ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Walker, the tight end in motion. Mariota from the gun on third down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Harrison Smith. And they will finally get him down as he's all the way to the 36-yard line. And out now come the Vikings. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
Here's Luck now on second down. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. On second down, they'll run with Gordon. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave them with a third and about four more for a first.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things. They've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
Walker, the tight end in motion. From the gun, Mariota. Going deep here for Matthews. They've got his man complete. Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
Mariota to throw it. And they get to Mariota here as he's dropped on the sack. Danielle Hunter in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Walker, the tight end, in motion. Third and long here for Mariota. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Fourth down, Mariota. And now here is another interception. Picked off by the linebacker, Eric Kendricks. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. After the interception, it's Locke. Now a hit, and Locke lost the football. It's out. It's picked up by the Titans. And they're set up in a golden position here right around the 10-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. They're calling luck or skill, whatever the case is. They're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, out of ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you retain possession, that's all you're looking for.
So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's second down. Play clock winding down. They go play action. Mariota. And this is going to be incomplete. And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect them.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
Boy, you'd hate to squander this great field position. Here's third and goal. They send Sharp in motion right. And the play clock's running down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Vikings pick up the football. Oh, jumping over. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. Past the 20. And they're going to bring this one back. It's a fumble return. A scoop and score for the Vikings. So they were down by a touchdown, probably just hoping the defense could hold them, maybe force the punt. Instead, they force the turnover and take it into the house.
Well, the plan was perfect. That's exactly what they wanted. Instead, they got a lot more than that. Big-time capitalization by taking the ball away and putting it in the end zone.
So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. This is taken at his four. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
On offense, the guy that you want to have the best eyes on the field are your quarterback, so you can see everything pre-snap, and then, of course, as a play develops. On defense, oftentimes it's the linebacker. And on this play, his eyes took him right to the ball, and he made a nice tackle.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now a second down throw for Mariota. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. Working out of the gun, Mariota. And he hits his man, Matthews. 15 yards through the air to first down.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Final minute now of the third quarter. Mariota now to throw on first down. He's going to look deep down the field. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And Matthews over the middle with a grab. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And some extras coming up on the line here, Redding for the blitz. Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Touchdown, Titans! Their dangerous wide receiver, 40 yards, and the Titans have taken the lead.
Brandon, what we just saw there were two guys who were in sync. The person delivering the ball, but especially the person running the route. Tremendous job. It results in a terrific play.
Now here's Succop out to kick it away. Archer, the return. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions. But some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Here's Luck now on second down. Evans has it left side. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
A lot of teams love to throw screen passes. They want to tire out defenses because they make them run a lot. But there are a lot of moving parts on a play for an offense when they call that one. Because you got the linemen that have to move. You got the wide receivers that have to get out and vacate. You got the running back that's got to make a little fake and then get out into the route. And of course, the quarterback, he's got to hold in there and know he's probably going to take a big hit before he lofts the screen off to the back. Why didn't he catch it? That's all he needed to do for them to be successful.
Luck on first down. Quick hitter here. It's complete. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. From the red zone now, Luck. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Mike Evans from 17 yards out. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And now a critical extra point attempt here. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. It's a short kick taken at the 15. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Throwing on third down, Luck. Throwing left side, it's complete. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. On first and 10, Luck. And a catch right side by Evans. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
To the air again, Luck. Incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there, and it's third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Tie game here. Time starting to run down. The defense really needs to try and keep this game tied, see if they can get the ball back for the offense. Now they go screen. It's complete. And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And Forbath will put this one through, and they take a 17-14 lead. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football. Here comes the D swarming to the line. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
And you see zone defense, and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call. You got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. Sets up the screen to Gordon. And some room to maneuver. The 20. Touchdown, Titans. Melvin Gordon, 66 yards. And the Titans have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. But he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it too before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
Archer, the return. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. He's back to throw. Now a hit and left. Lost the football. It's out. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Finding that he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Jurrell Casey in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Back to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. And that was incomplete, but I don't know how much of that falls on the quarterback. He was pressured.
Brandon, the rush showed up so fast, the quarterback had no chance to get the ball downfield.
Down four late. Got to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. Here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They have the lead. Still a one-possession game, but the defense got the stop. They've got the football now. Just salted away, right?
Exactly.
And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Second and goal from the five. Again, Gordon on second and goal. And he'll get this one back to the five-yard line, but no further than that. Another timeout called by the Vikings now. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Hey, we've got tight left.
Yeah, the defense definitely showing blitz here. Third and goal now. Ball on the five. So on third and goal, Gordon. And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. Melvin Gordon, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. And he knocks it through. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. This is taken at his four. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary?
Under pressure and down he goes. Luck is sacked. Derek Morgan in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. And Charles, in this situation, this is where the word miracle comes into play.
Have to score real fast, maybe throw a jump ball in the end zone and hope for the best.
To throw is luck. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. And the Titans getting set to go. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Man, confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Mariota here to throw. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. And that's a loss of 7 on the first down play. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Mariota now on second down. He sets to fire deep. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Harrison Smith. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here.
Come on, let's go!
Out of the Wildcat, a wide receiver carry.